Yeah, no doubt. It is a very Seattle pattern. Mostly cloudy skies, that spritzy, misty rain. Yeah. It's continuing out there, Amanda. Let me take you out to our HD sky cam. From this perspective, it doesn't look all that bad. As we're looking towards downtown Orlando, granted, you can't see the buildings from downtown Orlando because the clouds and even misting rains kind of masking it. As far as temperatures go, we're sitting at about 68 degrees, and near the airport, we're getting that rain around. Winds out of the north-northeast at 5. The wind's calming a bit tonight, and that's why I think that fog is going to be a little bit more of a concern through the overnight and into tomorrow. And take a look out our weather window in Daytona Beach. Our sky cam there usually shows the bridge and usually shows plenty of twinkling lights, but that's not the case now, as the fog and low cloud cover has basically settled in. Visibility numbers down to 2 miles in Daytona Beach, 1 mile for us in Palm Coast. The rest of Central Florida for now is okay, but I do expect overnight those numbers to come down, so you'll want to check in with WESH 2 News Sunrise before you get up and going tomorrow morning. Of course, we're on the air at 4:30 in the morning. Temperatures outside in the upper 60s for just about all of us, with the exception of Daytona and Ocala. Today's highs were in the low to mid 70s. Those clouds really kind of hung over us and did not allow much sunshine to heat us up. Looking at the infrared satellite imagery, you can see a bit of moisture sitting right over our eastern zones and basically bringing those clouds and showers ashore over the course of the day today. A few showers still around Celebration and I-4 right around the Disney complex. Also a couple of exiting showers here near the Space Coast. There's Melbourne up to Satellite Beach, and from time to time we'll see some more of this misting rain, but today it was a pretty decent rain for us. About 6/10 of an inch of rain in Melbourne, about 1/10 of an inch of rain in Cocoa. The rest of us just a trace here or there. Now, today we were getting all that moisture from a trough of low pressure that kind of set up shop just offshore, so it kept us socked in. But overnight tonight into tomorrow, that trough begins to move away from us, so I expect a little bit more sunshine for tomorrow. Temperatures falling through the 60s and fog developing. That's our forecast tonight. And before all is said and done, it's 59 Orlando, 54 degrees Ocala, about 55 Palm Coast, 57 degrees in Titusville. And then for your Monday, back to work, back to school, 73 your high in Claremont, 75 Orlando, 73 degrees in Daytona Beach, and a big weather story. We're tracking a cold front. That's going to help to slide through, clearing out the cloud cover, and by Tuesday morning, the winds shift around sufficiently enough that we really dry things out and actually bring the temperatures down just a little bit. So to sum it up, for your Monday, just a mention of a sprinkle. The fog starts us off, 75 your high, 53, a chillier start for your Tuesday morning, 76 your high temperature, and we're back into the 80s for your Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday.